Hello everyone, Sheffy back at you once again, with some more Kameo. This shouldn't be the very last episode, I think. I'm not completely sure if there's extra at the end. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this. Let's go ahead and get right into this fight with Thorn. Ouch. Well, that's already turning out really good. I do not remember his fight pattern, so this is all new to me. That's not, ouch. Huh. If you do something new every once in a while. Maybe with, oh crap, this isn't gonna end well. Is that doing damage? I suppose it is. Go ahead and back away a little bit, regain some of our health. Cool. I guess I could switch between the crystal eyes, but I don't really feel like doing that. I wonder if this does any damage. Ow. Yeah, it did some damage to me. Oh, okay. I couldn't tell if that was a laugh or... what was that? Okay, let's see. Ow. Not worry too much about the AoE. Once again, hurt myself. Yeah, getting up close and personal like this doesn't use as much mana, I don't think. And it also makes it where it doesn't do that downward punch as much. This is pretty cool. We get to see all the different kinds of trolls that he has. What's going on? Regaining some of his strength, I suppose. That was weird. Alright, and his fight pattern is a little bit different now. Probably not exactly the best way to do this, but I don't think I'm doing any damage now. Oh yeah, I am. Barely, but no wonder she thought, I guess I got stuck there for a second. No wonder she thought she could do it. I didn't want to do that. We made your ruin and what's your punch guy? Sorry, I'm trying to concentrate. No wonder she thought she could only do it with Major Ruin, Chilla, and what is that? Plant guy. Maybe I should switch to him. Pummelweed, that's his name. Well, this got difficult. I'm gonna switch over to where's he at? There he is. Holy crap, don't knock me off the edge. I don't even know if that's a thing that he can do. Oh, I guess that does do damage to him. Ouch. Ow. Okay, let's go ahead and try to get rid of these guys. Mainly just getting rid of them. Crap. Yeah, it's just easier to focus on him than anything. Except for these rock guys. These rock guys are pretty brutal. By the way, I am on normal or whatever the difficulties are. That's why this is all so easy. I don't know how it is on expert or whatever they want to call it. I guess she's casting the trolls down, so. I thought she was screaming and getting like blasted by him or something. Ouch. Maybe if I can suck these guys up. Nope, they're gone. Do these little blasts do anything to this guy? I definitely don't like having the wrong guys around. Now if I can suck these guys up, that would make this a little bit easier. Oh well. Ouch. Again, I'm sorry for being so quiet during this video, but this is a lot to concentrate on. Can't even tell if I'm doing damage. Yep, I guess I was. Alright, so the fight should change up a little bit more again. Why would I just give him time to rest like that? Oh, crap. That looks like it's going to be a little bit more difficult. I guess that does do some damage. I love how it's doing that swing noise, but it's like barely getting off the ground. Ow. That does do quite a bit of damage. Yeah, the best thing to do in this game is to level up the characters that I've been using the most. And to get as many of the health potions as possible. And to get that first crystal eye. I'm not even going to worry about these guys. Doing pretty good so far, I guess. Going pretty quickly. Only taking me 7 minutes so far to beat him. Or get him down this far, not to beat him. Probably about 9 to 10 minutes to beat him, I think. Depending on if my freaking mana stuff comes back. Obviously, the best thing to do is just keep your distance with the spinning thing. Come on now. And don't really worry about the AoE if you have this specific eye on, because it doesn't really matter too much. The AoE doesn't do enough damage to you on this difficulty with this much health and with that crystal ion. Can I suck that up? That'd have been cool. And he's just about dead at 8 minutes 59 seconds. 9 minutes pretty much. Nice. Cool. Now do I just have to beat the AoE or something? Oh, is she healing him? Is that what that is? Okay, let's see. I definitely want to freaking get him out. Not what I wanted. I don't think she really can heal him up. Oh, I was wrong. Never mind at the 9 minute mark. Okay, Chilla and Thermite are your two best bets for this battle. Well, at the end of the battle. So these three guys are probably your best bet for this battle. Ow. Come on. I mean, I guess I could have just sucked these people up. Oh crap. I guess he wasn't dead yet. Trying to save up some of my mana. Holy crap. He's gating me. For some reason, he's just like gained a lot of difficulty. Alright. Now, time to just focus on her. Oh, that thing helped me out a little bit. Sweet. So I'll probably get her about halfway or a little bit more, I guess. Before she gets him rezzed. Oh, never mind, I got him. Alright, that was it. So, 11 minutes, and I beat him. But I'll be quiet now so y'all can hear this.
Your family betrayed you, Kallus. Chose an orphan over their own blood.
What?
Zolon, you must leave immediately and tell no one of the journey. Don't worry, my king. I will tell your family where you went, should they need to know.
I cannot believe it.
Mystic is a traitor. She's been manipulating us both all along.
You're as gullible as your father was.
And you. You murdered my father. But now I will finish what he started.
Dang. This is really not the time to hug. She's like, nah, you're not gonna die that easy.
Kameo, tell our family. I'm sorry.
Wow, that's pretty awesome. Sorry, I was like, I just saw myself on the camera, but I was really focusing on that. Again, this is the first time I've beat this since I was like, Xbox came out in 2008, I think. I don't even know how old I was. I'll have to do the math here in a minute. I was like 16 whenever I beat this. 15 or 16, I think. First time. And there we go. We beat Kameo. That was like I said many a times throughout this playthrough, one of my favorite Xbox 360 games that I remember owning. Aside from the Halo franchise, I got into the Halo franchise during the Xbox 360 era. So that's my favorite out of all the Xbox games. But anyways, Kameo, definitely a game that, even though you watch me play this, I definitely recommend you guys playing it yourself. Let me go ahead and turn this music down. I think there's some stuff after the credits, so I'm going to let the credits play through. But yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this game. I really love this game. I cannot recommend it enough. Just a beautiful example of what the Xbox 360 could do at the beginning of its life cycle. You know, obviously, other games like Halo 4 and stuff like that really brought it back to life into the later years of the Xbox 360. But yeah, this beautiful game, beautiful little story it had going on for a Rare game. Yeah, you know, definitely pick up the Rare Replay. I'm thinking about getting it, playing some of the games that were on it. Let me take this off. I can barely hear myself. Plug this in. Sorry about that. But yeah, just beautiful game. Beautiful, beautiful game. You know, very first time that I saw blood come up on the screen, like I mentioned at the beginning of the game. Very glad that I replayed it, actually. Really showed how easy it was, even though it was really hard for me whenever I was playing it a long time ago. I guess it kind of shows that I've progressed a little bit in my playing video games aspect. I really don't play that many video games realistically, but I do enjoy a good story, and that's why I enjoy video games so much. And speaking of which, you know, I'm definitely planning on doing a walkthrough of, what is that game called, Undertale. But after that, I don't really have that many games to choose from, but I do have some games that I would like to play with you guys. I might leave them down in the description so you guys can kind of leave a poll. But I would like to maybe do Dark Souls. Dark Souls 3 is coming out pretty soon. It is, let me see, it is, I think March, hold on one second. I think it's March 19th. Let me check. Yes, it's March 19th and it comes out April something. So I want to play that. Ratchet and Clank 5, I think it is coming out soon. And I'd absolutely love playing that. That was, aside from Jak and Daxter, that was my second favorite franchise on the PlayStation 2. It was Ratchet and Clank, or it was Jak and Daxter, Ratchet and Clank, and Sly Cooper were my three favorite games for the PlayStation 2. So I'd love to play that with you guys. So, you know, if you think of something that you guys want me to play, I'll leave the games that I have and what I have not played. I played Halo 5. I'm thinking about doing Halo 1, 2, and 3, and maybe ODST as well. I think I have Reach as well. I would like to play that. So it'd probably be Reach 1, 2, ODST 3, and then 4. And then you guys can go back and watch Halo 5. So yeah, I don't know if I can skip these credits or not. I don't have enough to say to go through all these credits. I guess it's getting pretty close to the end. It's already showing stuff from the end of the game. But yeah, again, play the crap out of Kameo, bring it back to life. If you guys are YouTubers and stuff, do a video of you playing Kameo. I absolutely love watching you guys play it. Obviously, I skipped through a lot of the stuff. I just mainly did the main story stuff. There was some stuff where you could do some, like, battle training and some little side quests and stuff like that. Not a lot. This obviously is not like Skyrim or something like that, which I do have that too. I could play that for you guys as well. But it's not like Skyrim where you're supposed to explore the whole entire thing, but, you know. Okay, this is the end of the credits. I don't know if they're going to have anything else at the end of it, but we'll see. Oh, she is. Oh, nope. Let me turn this down just a little bit. Let's see what happens if I open it back up and go back in there real quick. I don't want to go into expert mode. I think it restarts it or sends me back into the... I can't remember. Sends me back to the beginning of the game. Not the beginning, but then this place. Yeah. So there we go, and we can go explore, and we can go get some more fruits. Oh yeah. So I wanted to show you guys where I did get my, where I did get my red, what is it called? Red crystal eye. I don't know where I get the purple one from. Oh, thank you. The funny thing is, after I got the 999 pouch, I really didn't need it anymore. So, where do I go? I mean, the graphics aren't perfect for nowadays, like for the Xbox One, 360, I mean, Xbox One, PS4, all that good stuff. But just take for granted that, or don't take for granted, but keep in mind that this game was made in, I think it was 2008, I'm not sure, 2008, 2009, somewhere around there. And it's 2016, so this is like a 8-year-old game or something like that. I don't remember the exact dates, but it's an older game, so, yeah. So, there's a giant thorn statue right here, and you take out this guy, and you blow it up, and yeah, you get your red eye. And this mirror right here is what I was also kind of talking about, where you can go back and play certain aspects, which I'm going to have to do because I need to redo my first video. But yeah, you can go back and do all the very first, all the big quests. I guess I can't do the beginning again with that. Oh well, you can do all the temples and stuff. That's what I'm trying to say. So yeah, let me get somewhere cool so I can end this. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed every minute of this like I enjoyed every minute of it. I truly appreciate it if you did stick through all the episodes with me. Again, I just absolutely love this game. I cannot get over how much I love this game and how much I do recommend it for you guys. Especially if you like the collecting aspect of it, where you collect all the different monsters and stuff like that, kind of like Pokemon and stuff. And the little details, you can pay attention to any of the areas and find little things. Like I saw in the ocean place where one of the little fish people was jumping off a cliff into the water. So that was a little thing. But anyways, as always, stay beautiful, stay sexy, and stay chefy. I love you guys.